Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The topic I'm going to talk today is breaking chains and every problem in your life. Breaking chains and every problem in your life. And I'm going to read from the book of Zechariah 4 verse 7. The Bible says, "Who art thou, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel? Thou shalt become a plain, and he shall bring forth the headstone thereof, which shalt cry grace, grace unto it. Who art thou, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel, that shall become a plain, and he shall bring forth the headstone thereof, which shalt cry grace, grace." Who is that great mountain? Who is that great? Every mountain will be bring to brain. Every mountain standing against you will be brain before you in the name of Jesus Christ. That's why today, this month, everything that has been mountain, everything that has been high, God is going to bring them down in the name of Jesus. Every chain, God is going to break them. Every problem in your head, God is going to destroy them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. In the book of 2 Timothy 4 verse 8 says, "And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work, and will preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be the glory forever and ever." The Lord will deliver you. That is the scripture you have to read for yourself. You meditate this scripture. You say, "And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work." Read 2 Timothy 4 verse 18. The Lord shall deliver me from every evil work and preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be the glory forever and ever. So the Lord will deliver you. The Lord will deliver me from every evil work and preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom. So the Lord himself is going to deliver you from every evil work, anything which is evil, every chain in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, my sister. The Lord shall deliver you from every evil work. The Lord is going to break every chain, every evil work in your life. The Lord is going to deliver you. Every evil. That's why every problem in your life, the Lord is going to destroy them. No matter what you are going through, no matter the situation you are facing today, the Lord Almighty is going to destroy them. The Lord is going to deliver you in the name of Jesus Christ. It doesn't matter the situation you are around. When you call upon this God, he will deliver you from every evil work. Every evil, anything of the devil, the Lord is going to deliver you and preserve you unto his heavenly kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's look in the book of Joshua 1, verse 5. The book of Joshua 1, verse 5. The Bible says, "There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life, as I was with Moses. So I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee." The Bible says, "There shall not any man be able to stand before you all the days of thy life, as I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not fail you or forsake you." God is talking to you right now that the way he was with, like with Moses, the way God has promised that he will never forsake you, he will never fail you, he will never forsake you, no man will stand against you. This is the promise of God. No man. They said, "There shall not any man be able to stand before you. No man, no human being, no demons, no witchcraft, no power, no powers of oppression, no powers of witchcraft will stand against you." The Lord has promised. These are the, some of the promise that God has promised you. He said, no witchcraft will stand against you, start witching you. If any witch have prospered in your life, you have the power and the authority. Remember 2 Timothy, what it says, evil work from witchcraft. And here, Joshua is talking, is saying, no man, so there is no man. And the Bible says, there shall be no enchantment. Numbers 23:26 says, there is no witchcraft, there is no enchantment, there is no problem, there is no devil, there is no power of the kingdom of darkness will stand against you. In the name of Jesus Christ, you have to stand with the word of God. You believe the word of God and it shall establish to you. Jesus said, believe in me. Believe also in my Father's house. Believe the word of God. It shall be established in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Meditate upon the name, the scripture, that there shall be no man who will be able to stand before you all the days of your lives. There is no man. This is a promise. God has promised no man will stand against you. Every fire, every power of darkness, wherever stands against you, may the Lord destroy him. Every evil work, anything that the enemy is using against your life, will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. The Bible has promised us, and that is what we go with it. The Bible says in Psalms 27 verse 2, says, when the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they shall stumble. Hallelujah. When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they shall stumble. So, there is enemy called eaters of flesh and drink of blood. When the enemy comes to eat you up, when the enemy comes with their wicked, the Lord says they will stumble and fall down. So there is no way the wicked will come and succeed in your life unless he has legal right. There is a permission that he has come and destroy you. If the enemy come and arrest you, then there is a legal, there is something that has allowed him to come to you. Because the promise has said, the evil will not come near you. The evil will not work on you. The Bible says, the wicked, even your enemies, they may come, but they will stumble in the name of Jesus. So we pray that God will break and destroy every hidden enemies in your body, wherever it is, or whatever the enemy is, it will be destroyed in the name of Jesus. You shall silence every enemy concerning your family, concerning you and your family. We are going to pray. We are going to pray that the prayer point 34 we stopped yesterday. We are going to pray, silence every voice of the enemy concerning your family and concerning you and your family in the name of Jesus. I silence every voices of the enemy concerning my family, concerning me and my family in the name of Jesus. That is a prayer you pray. You silence every voices of the enemy concerning you and your family in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you have to silence. You have to silence every voices of the enemy concerning your family and your concerning you and your family. You command you evil voices. I silence you. I silence you in the name of Jesus Christ. I silence every voices of the enemy. Every voices of the enemy, I silence you. Sometimes you might see the birds coming and making noise, dogs, cats making unnecessary noise. They have been sent by the devil. They have been sent by the witchcraft to come and make noise on your door, and their noise has a mission. So you silence their voice. You command them, I silence every voice of the enemy concerning me and my family in the name of Jesus. When you pray such a prayer, anything that is making noise against you, and even in your head, you may hear voices. Those people who are suffering from depression or who hears voices, you silence them. You say, I command you, I silence you in the name of Jesus. You have to silence because you have been given authority. Scatter all terrors of the night by fire in Jesus' name. Scatter every terrors of the night. there is terrors of the night. Some people, they don't sleep. When they go to sleep, they are terrifying. There's a man who doesn't sleep. This man has been calling me almost the whole night. He has been having the terror of the night. He calls me. I had to put off the phone. Because he calls me, he thinks that I'm God. I told him that I'm not God. I'm just a human being. Like, I'm not God. I prayed for him, but he was really in a terrible situation. He was terrified. Even this morning, he started calling me. I had to beg him and say, please, I'm starting my meeting. Don't bring destruction now. Stop. So people are tormented. Deep people are going through the terrors of the night. Therefore, you scatter them. You command every terrors of the night, I scatter you by fire. You scatter every dreams that came to you while you are sleeping. You scatter them. Every terrors of the night, you scatter them. You command them to be scattered in the name of Jesus. Command every area challenging your destiny. Command every witchcraft challenging your destiny to die in Jesus' name. Command, if you think you are being witched, or there's witchcraft in your family, or witchcraft are attacking you, this is the prayer that you can pray. You command every witchcraft challenging your destiny to die. The Bible has said witchcraft shall not live. So you command, you say, every witchcraft challenging my destiny, challenging my life, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to die. You command them to die. They will die and leave you in Jesus' name. Every witchcraft challenging your destiny, command them to die in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Ask the power of God to uproot every wicked plantation in your life and your family in Jesus' name. Ask the power of God to uproot every wicked plantation in your life and your family in Jesus' name. You ask God, God, I ask you to uproot every wicked plantation in my life and my family in Jesus' name. Any wicked plantation planted by wicked in my family and my life, I destroy them. You ask God, you ask Jesus, ask the power of God to uproot every wicked plantation in your life and your family in Jesus' name. Yes, command every evil power that has polluted your parents. Okay. Command every evil power that has pursued your parents to release you. The power that pursued your parents, command them to get out of your life in Jesus' name. What your parents went through, you will not go through. In Jesus' name. If your parents have some sickness, or your parents, they died, or the parents, they are being attacked by poverty, so you cannot let those demons to come to you. You command every evil power that has pursued your parents to release you in Jesus' name. You command them, release me. You release me. You, the powers of my parents, release me in Jesus' name. All evil powers of my parents, release me, because you are a different person. You don't belong to your parents anymore. In the name of Jesus. Even your parents were witchcraft, they cannot affect you with their witches. If are initiating you with witchcraft, even your parents were thieves, criminals, so you cannot let them, that spirit, their problem to come to you. So you command them to release you and let you go in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Call the fire of God and the thunder of God to pursue your pursuers in Jesus' name. Call the fire of God and the thunder of God to pursue your pursuers in Jesus' name. You command fire of God and the thunder of God, pursue my pursuers in the name of Jesus. You command them to pursue your pursuers in the name of Jesus. Ask the Holy Ghost fire to purge the blood from Satan injection in the name of Jesus. Some people, they are injected. They get dreams that they are injected. They have been shot. So you ask the Holy Ghost fire to purge the blood of Jesus from satanic injection in the name of Jesus. If you've been receiving injection while you are sleeping, people come, you see the injection, they come and inject you. The demon inject you, or you have been shot. This is the time you pray that the Holy Ghost fire to purge the blood of Jesus from satanic injection in the name of Jesus Christ. You ask the blood, you purge the blood of Jesus into your system, and it will destroy anything the enemy has injected you. You know, some people, they receive some sickness, HIV, AIDS, virus through injection. People have no ideas. Some sickness that people get, they get through satanic injection. I don't know if you have seen this. They will come with the needle and they start injecting you. So you command the blood of you, you pass the blood of Jesus. Then the blood of Jesus will wash everything they have done to you in Jesus' name. Command every evil power of your father's house and every herbal power to die. Every power of your father's house, this has the power that is affecting many people. So you command them to die. You command them to get out of your life in Jesus' name. Every power, every evil powers of my father's house and every apple powers to die in the name of Jesus. You command them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Command every witchcraft tree binding your placenta to die in the name of Jesus. You don't know where is your placenta. This is another topic I may teach about the placenta. Placenta is a big, big market. It's the biggest market in the world. Even if you give birth to your child, try to ask that I need the placenta of my child. Ask why they are keeping the placenta. The placenta is something that is very important to the body of the human being. So the witches and wizards, they will buy and go to do wicked with your placenta. Placenta is now doing a lot of work. So for good or for evil, now we command every witchcraft tree binding your placenta to die. Command that wherever your placenta is, for evil, whatever they are, command them to die in the name of Jesus. You speak, you can even hold your belly like this. You say, I command every witchcraft tree binding my placenta to die in the name of Jesus. You pray like that prayer. You command the witchcraft binding your placenta to die in the name of Jesus Christ. Command every dream sponsored by witchcraft against you, your family, to die. Every dream sponsored by witchcraft against my life and my children, I command you to die in the name of Jesus. Command witchcraft dreams sponsored by witchcraft to die and be vanished. They will not manifest. They will not work in your life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Command every demon that causes you to eat in your dreams and have sex in your dream, flee in your dreams, talk in your dreams, swim in your dreams, cry in your dreams, cast out demons in your dreams. You know, there are people who are being cursed, who are fed, they eat in dreams. They have sex in dreams. They fly in the dreams. They talk in dreams. So all this, you have to command them to die. This is the death sentences is the best that you can command the enemy. That feed you in the dreams, that make you to have sex in your dreams, that make you to fly in your dreams, talking in your dreams, swimming in your dreams, cry your dreams, cast out demons in your dreams. So you command them to die in the name of Jesus. You command every demon that caused me to eat in my dreams, I command you to die. Every dream that makes me to have sex in the dream, I destroy you, I cut you off, I command you to die in Jesus' name. Use death sentences to every demon that is working against you. People think that the demon, they don't die. I know that's what we believe, that's what even myself, I believe that what makes me to feel that this demon, they can be damaged and they can be destroyed, is that Jesus Christ came to destroy the works of the devil. When he came to destroy the work of the devil, which means it destroyed them, it cannot go. Now, Jesus sent the pigs to the sea and they drowned there and died there. So, whatever it happened to them, I don't know, but they will be destroyed. They will be destroyed and they will be vanished in Jesus' name. If I can't use the name die, so I can use destroyed in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed. If something is destroyed, it means death. It cannot live. Jesus came to destroy every work of the devil. Therefore, whether the demons or whatever it is, Jesus has destroyed them. You pray, I destroy every satanic dream that feed me in my dream, that make me to eat in the dreams, that make me to have sex in the dream. I kill you. I destroy you. I destroy you in the name of Jesus. That's how you pray. Command every power of the devil that interferes with your good dreams, makes you forget your good dreams, or bring horrible dreams to die. In the name of Jesus, those power must die. Those power must be destroyed in the name of Jesus. The power that interferes with your good dreams. When you have good dreams, but you forget that dreams. So there's powers like that. So you command them to die. You destroy them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Dash into pieces every dream of poverty in the name of Jesus. Dash to pieces. Every poverty, I dust you to pieces. Every evil dreams of poverty in Jesus' name, you dust them to pieces in Jesus' name. That's how you destroy, you break every chain, you break everything that is working against you in every area in Jesus' name. Commanding evil strangers to come out of your destiny in Jesus' name. Command every evil strangers, any stranger in your body, any strange, command them to come out from your destiny in Jesus' name. I command evil strangers to come out of my destiny, to come out from my destiny in the name of Jesus. Command every satanic animals programmed into your dreams life. Every satanic animals programmed into your dream life, command them to die. There are some animals, very dangerous animals. Maybe you see a lot of bulls, you see animals programmed in your dream, command them to die. Those are witchcraft animals. Command them to die in the name of Jesus. Command every witchcraft witch doctor searching for your face to receive the fire of God. Command every witch doctors searching your life in the face. You know there are some witchcraft, they use mirror, they use some method to search your face. Command them to receive fire. Command them to receive fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. Command every serpent and scorpion portion in your life and your destiny to come out in Jesus' name. Command every serpent and scorpion. Pray every serpent and scorpion portion in your life and destiny to come out in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Command every evil spoken against your destiny before you are born to die. You know, when a child is born, the first one who receive you, they might say negative or good things. Now, those ones, they can affect your destiny forever. So you command evil spoken against your destiny before you are born to die. Maybe your mother wanted to have a boy or a girl, then the boy come. So the mother will say something which is negative. It would affect the destiny of that child. That's why you see many children are suffering. Because of what the parents or whoever received the child the first day the child was born. The word that they spoke against that child. That's why you need to be very careful when you say any word for your child. Even if when he's in the womb, make sure you stock good words. You say things for your baby that will prosper your child. You command them to that you command every evil spoken against your destiny before you are born to die. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. All animals of your progress and increase to be scattered in the name of Jesus. Command all enemies of your progress and increase to be scattered in the name of Jesus. Command them. Command every all evils of your progress and increase to be scattered. Every enemies of your progress and your increase scatter in the name of Jesus. You command them to scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. Ask God to open your spiritual eyes and ears to see in the name of Jesus. One of the sisters was asking us to pray for her mother for her eyes and ears to be open. So even you need the ears, spiritual ears to open. You need spiritual eyes to open in the name of Jesus. You ask my God, open my eyes to see, open my ear to hear. So you ask God to open your spiritual eyes, your spiritual ears to hear in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Command every generational spirit reporting you reporting your past to your future to depart by fire in Jesus' name. Command every generation of spirit reporting your past to your future to depart by fire. That's how you command them. This prayer, it is going to deliver you and break every chain and break and destroy every problem in your life. When you pray every generation of spirit reporting your past to your future to depart by fire in Jesus' name, they will depart in the name of Jesus Christ. Command every dark power working against your family to die. Every dark power working against my family, die in the name of Jesus. Every dark power working against my family, working against my family. That's how you pray. Command every dark power working against your family to die in the name of Jesus Christ. Command every witchcraft of stagnation of your progress to die. There is a video called stagnation. So you command every witchcraft of stagnation of your progress to die. These powers of stagnation, they make you to stuck. You cannot move your grounding like that water. You become stagnant. Nothing, no progress. Nothing working for you. So please, if you are the one of them, you can pray this prayer like wounded lion, like mad prophets. You pray very hard and very loud. I command every witchcraft stagnance in my progress to die. Get out of my progress. You wicked and evil witchcraft, get out in the name of Jesus. You command them. You must be very aggressive. You don't joke with these powers. They have made people to be stagnant. They cannot move. They don't have anything. If a man from this country, Baram, is it Bahanam? This man has been in the country for many years and he has nothing. This is a spirit of stagnance that has made him that he cannot have anything, can't achieve anything. So you command them, and it is about his witchcraft. You command every witchcraft stagnation of your progress to die. You don't let this witchcraft stagnance you. You have power to pray against them. You remember those scriptures that I gave you. Meditate upon them and pray these prayers. Take even one prayer. Pray even 1 hour. If you are being stagnant and you take this prayer, you pray even 1 hour, just one prayer point, your life will never be the same again. Every gauge in your father's house, die. There are gauges in your father's house. That is all in you. That makes you that you cannot go far. You are engaged. You cannot. You can't. You try this, but you know when you are engaged, you are being engaged. So your world is being engaged. Nothing. You have no power. You the demon can do you anything they want because you are in the gauge. Even the lion. When the lion is in the cage, you can do anything. The lion has no power. He can't do you anything because he cannot cut the cage to come and attack you. So that gate of your father's house, I command them to be breaking pieces in the name of Jesus. That gate of your father's house, I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. You pray every gate in my father's house, I command you to die, destroy it, cut them in Jesus' name, so that you can have freedom in the name of Jesus. Command every power eating your food and drinking your water, but planning for your destruction to lose its power. You know, there are powers, they drink your water before you drink, they eat your food before you eat. So you command them to get out and go in the name of Jesus, to lose their direction in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Command resident wickedness in your family to die. Every resident wickedness in your family and in your family, let them die. There's some wicked resident, wicked one. They live there to wait for you, to attack you, to attack your children, to attack everything. They want to kill you. You know wickedness is bad. Household wickedness, witchcraft, household wickedness, they are so bad. They are waiting to destroy your life. You can't move because they know you. Every progress, anything you do, they are moving. You can't do anything. So you command them to die in the name of Jesus. Command every bad luck of witchcraft in your family to burn up in the name of Jesus Christ. Command them to burn up, to burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Every bad luck of witchcraft in your family to burn up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. command every witchcraft hand that carried you as a baby to break in the name of Jesus. Command every witchcraft hand that carried you as a baby to break in Jesus' name. You know, people, they say, we don't believe witchcraft. We don't believe, but many, many, many people are being attacked by witchcraft. Churches, people are going to church, many thousands of people, because of ignorance, they are being attacked and they don't know what to do. Why are you being attacked? Why are you sick? Why are you having all this problem? You are in the church, you are doing everything, but you are facing a very tough problem, a very tough situation. Why? These are the work of the witchcraft. This is the hand of the witchcraft. Therefore, you break them, you destroy them in Jesus' name. Every mountain of darkness hiding your progress, you command them to die. Every mountain of darkness hiding your progress, command them to die in the name of Jesus. Every strange child in your family to lose its power. They are strange children in your family. Children of the devil. Strange children are children of the devil. So the children of the devil can be in your family and you have no idea. So you command them to lose their power in Jesus' name. Command every inherited witchcraft in your family to die. Command every inherited witchcraft in your family to die. Command every owner of witchcraft rods to cut them and go back in Jesus' name. Let every witchcraft doctor consulted against you for his power to disgrace him in Jesus' name. Let every witch doctor consultant against you for his power to be disgraced in the name of Jesus. Command every witchcraft embargo on your finances to die in the name of Jesus. Command every witchcraft embargo of your finances to die in the name of Jesus. There is witchcraft embargo that is working against the people, against your finances. When embargo has been placed on your finances, no matter what you can do, you will not have money. Because embargo has been placed in your money. Embargo has been placed on your finances. You can see money, but nothing you can do with money. The money comes and you use it. You squander the money because it cannot stay in you. People comes and borrow you. People comes and beg you money. Everybody is asking you money. So you can't keep money. You can't have money. Problem, debt, everything. If you are from other country like us, you will hear somebody's dead, sickness, things is happening. So all your money will go there. It will not help anything. So you command that embargo to die in the name of Jesus Christ. Command every witchcraft calendar in your life to die in Jesus' name. You know there is witchcraft calendar like month end. When month ends like this, they are coming and take everything you have worked for. Or they bring sickness, or they bring something every month or every certain time. They are called witchcraft calendar. So you command them to die in the name of Jesus Christ. Command witchcraft calendar to die. The calendar, they know that this month, this time, it's something will happen to you. And they fold the calendar. So you destroy their calendar. You command their calendar to die in the name of Jesus. Command the fundamental arrows of witchcraft to die in the name of Jesus. Command the foundational witchcraft of your father's house to die in the name of Jesus. Backfire arrows of witchcraft from the sun and the moon. You can command every witchcraft arrows from the sun and the moon. I fire you back. I command you to go back in the name of Jesus. Backfire them. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Every arrows of witchcraft from the sun and the moon. Backfire. 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 You command them to backfire in Jesus' name. This prayer, the witchcraft, they don't want. When it backfire, it destroys them. They feel bad. You pray very aggressive because they want to destroy your life. They've been speaking with the sun and moon. They want to destroy. You backfire them. Let them go back to the sender. Destroy every water and animal's powers in your life. Every water and animal's powers in your life, destroy them. Command every spiritual marriage with water spirit in your life and your family to die in the name of Jesus. Destroy every satanic transfer of evil names in your family in Jesus' name. There are satanic evil transfer of names Maybe they call you the names of which inviting the demon to attack you. You command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Say your name, your country, your clan, and destroy every spiritual meaning of your name. You can say your name, your country, and your clan, and destroy every spiritual meaning of your names in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Say, my God, my Father. Include all the, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. My God, I want to praise your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Say, perpetuous, any of you, my names, including surname, is that of a demon, idol, liver, or a stream, or evil person, man, bitter ocean, market day, evil day, season that glorifies the devil, I destroy every spiritual meaning in it, in the name of Jesus. So you command every demon, anything that means bitter, whatever it is, if it means your name, you destroy them in Jesus' name. Command strength of infirmity to depart by fire in Jesus' name. Command strangers of infirmities to depart in Jesus' name. Force strangers to come out of your of their hiding places in Jesus' name. Command arrows fired into your life as a baby to depart in Jesus' name. Command every deposit in your life to be destroyed. Happen when you dream it or being fed in your dreams or you have spiritual husband. Command them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Spirit husband in your dream, let them die. Spirit husband, spirit wife, spirit husband, let them die and let them be fans in Jesus' name. Command strangers, hallelujah. Command strangers of infirmities to depart by fire. Programmed sickness, spiritual bad luck, evil marks, identification, extra. Command them to die. Command them to get out of your life in Jesus' name. Break every yoke of inherited poverty forever in Jesus' name. Break every inherited poverty forever in Jesus' name. Break every yoke of inherited poverty forever in the name of Jesus. You know there's power of poverty, of inherited. Like your family, your background, they are poor. So you have to take a step and break them. Break that yoke of your inheritance. Break every yoke of inherited poverty forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Break them. Arrest agents of monetary distress in the name of Jesus. Break them and destroy them in Jesus' name. Cut every pursuer separate pieces. Cut every pursuer in separate to pieces in Jesus' name. Separate that is following you. You see them dreams. Cut them off. Cut them pieces in the name of Jesus Christ. Release turnaround breakthroughs in your life in Jesus' name. Pray like this. Oh Lord, send forth your angels to the storehouse of my blessings and the blessings of my family. Let them loose and release my blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Let the voice of the Lord thunder over my enemies and over every voices that speak against me and silence them forever in the name of Jesus. Amen. Pray. Pray these prayers in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God, we thank you. These are the prayers that you need to pray. You pray like this. You know, if you don't have these prayers, email me. Send me email. I will send them, all of them, to you. If you need these prayers, it will help you. You pray like this. If you have your prayers, pray with me. Pray like this. Oh Lord, send forth your angels to the storehouse of my blessings and blessings of my family. Let them loose and release my blessings in Jesus' name from every power of Satan. You pray that prayers like that. You pray like this. Let the voice of the Lord thunder over my enemies and over every voices that speaks against me and silence them forever in the name of Jesus. You pray these prayers, it will deliver you. I thank God that we are able to finish all these prayers, the cleansing prayers, day 1, 2, 3. Today we are day 3, and evening we are going to have deliverance, massive deliverance. Many people are going to be delivered. So you pray strangers in the body, including programmed hiding, hidden sickness, spiritual bad luck, evil marks, and identification to die and to be vanished in Jesus' name. Spirit does not die. But when we say let them die, they should become functionless, useless, and disappear. It means we render them powerless. When the spirit do not die, but when we say let them die, they should become functionless. They become functionless, useless, and disappear. It means we render them powerless. Strange children imply agents of destruction who monitoring and report what happens in your family. Everyone has a fire in the spiritual world. Some people's life have been passed to many agents of darkness, which has even they die, transfer the fire. So do not pray for them to die, but for the power behind them to die. Then the power become untransferable in the name of Jesus. Every power behind the enemy, behind the witchcraft, all these powers shall die so that they cannot be transferred to you. I thank God that God, thank you, Lord, that God, we are able to finish this prayer. Thank you that we are able to finish 3 days prayer and fasting. And we will end this evening in the deliverance, the iron feet. Thank you very much. Thank you for joining. Thank you. God bless you so much. I love you so much. I am able to finish this. So the videos will be there. Video day 1 and day 2 and day 3. So all the prayers, I'm going to put them under the videos. If you want to watch them, if you want to pray them, I'm going to put them under the video. So they will be on YouTube. The yesterday videos, all the prayers will be there. And today prayers will be there also. So go to YouTube, get them. Go to our website, Overcomers. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. Also, you can reach us. You can reach me in texting this number. We have our cell phone. We have landline. Wherever you can use, or you can send us your text message. Our number is 647-608-5207. And our landline number is 905-487-7196. Thank you very much. God bless you. 905-487-196. That's the number. Our cell phone number, it is on the screen. If you are using Periscope, you can copy that number. There's no way you call me, give me the number, and the number is there. You can stop and you can write that number. My sister Deborah is doing a great job. Thank you, my sister. Thank you so much. Thank you. Also, remember to sow any seed. You can sow an amount. We don't have to request you the amount you can sow. You can give even $5. It's better than nothing. You can sow $1,000. You can sow even $10,000. Wherever you can afford, God will bless you. If this ministry is blessing you, so. Some people, they want to use me as a slave. They want to work on me. They call me prayer. I pray for them. They want to use me. They don't know that if I can sit down and serve everybody like that, then I can't have even food to eat. Because they want me to be a slave for them. They cannot appreciate. Some people, they call me all every day, pray for me. But they have never even given this ministry. So if you think this ministry is blessing you, donate, bless us. Bless me. Bless the ministry. If you love me, send me some love offering. If you have been enjoying this ministry as helping you. If you love me, if you want to buy me some tea, some coffee, some lunch, send me. Give me love offering. I've been with you. I've been praying for you. I'm studying with you. So I love you so much. If you love me, buy me tea, buy me food, buy me lunch, take me lunch. Send me love offering, and I love you so much. That's why I know you love me and I love you. Because I do everything for you to see that God is in you and you are signing. I am destroying all these works of the enemy. People have been attacked. People, they call me anytime at night, wherever they want. And I respond to them. I have four rhymes. They call me and I answer them. Tell me who has ever called me and I don't answer them. I answer them. All these thousands of people are calling me from all over the world. Now they want me that I will be praying for them. Praying. They don't want to give. They don't want to show to our ministry. So I'm praying that God will speak to you one of these days and you will donate a big amount. Because this prayer is helping you. I thank God so much. I love you. God bless you so much. See you 7:30 p.m. 7:30 p.m. We'll start our deliverance prayer. So if you have the number, the prayer line number once again, those who have that number, please pull it out. Then the prayer line number is 712-775-7085. Please, Deborah, write it down. Because people are asking me, what is the number? What is the number? Then the prayer line number, buy the card, if you don't have long distance. 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. The number is 712-775-7085. Access code number is 595119. The access code number is 595119. You see, that is the number. You stop the screen, you copy that number. Please don't ask me all the time, what is the number? What is the number? If you don't know, the number is in the video. The YouTube, if you look at the YouTube, the number is there. All our numbers, all our contact are there. So if you are viewing our videos and you want to call me, the number is there. So you can reach me. The prayer line number is there and all our contacts are there. Please get them and call me. Let me help you where I can. Also, don't forget to join us tonight, 7:30 deliverance prayer. God bless you and have a wonderful time. I love you. Happy Canada Day. Happy once again. I pray that God will bless you. That's why I'm wearing Canada Day, red and white, and I look like this. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I want to thank God and I bless God. I give God glory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God is good. God is good. We thank God. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. God bless you and have a wonderful time. Thank you, my sister Treasure. Thank you, all of you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Yes, we thank God for everyone. Yeah. Thank you so much. Happy Canada Day. Canada Day. Today we are celebrating Canada Day. That's why after our breaking fasting, we are going to eat turkey. We are going to eat good food. We are going to eat Jamaican food. We are going to eat Indian food. We are going to eat Canadian food. We are going to eat African food. There will be a lot of food. What is this called? There's another food I was told. It is coming. So, because our ministry is Madpo culture, so many people are bringing their culture of food. So I wish you could be here and join us. God bless you so much. So join us 7:30 p.m. today, Friday. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Bye-bye. Bye. Yes, I will enjoy for you.